अब नेशनवाइड प्रोटेस्ट एंड एजिटेशन ओवर द कोलकाता डॉक्टर रेप केस. कोलकाता पुलिस इज इम्पोस्ड प्रोहिबिशनरी ऑर्डर्स अंडर सेक्शन 163 ऑफ बीएनएसएस फॉर 7 days विद इफेक्ट फ्रॉम टुडे टू प्रिवेंट एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ अनलॉफुल असेंबली. द एमएचए ऑल्सो इन द मीनवाइल इज सॉट टू आवरली रिपोर्ट फ्रॉम द बंगाल गवर्नमेंट ऑन द लॉ एंड ऑर्डर सिचुएशन. द स्टेट पुलिस इज ऑल्सो समन टू डॉक्टर्स. Also, a BJP leader, Lokit Chatterjee, for allegedly revealing the identity of the victim and also spreading misinformation. In the latest, though, the CBI has started the psychological test of the main accused, Sanjay Roy. In this case, the former principal of the RJ Kar Hospital is also at the CBI office for the third round of questioning today.
सबसे पहले तो अभी तक मेरे पास कुछ समझ नहीं आया. और दूसरा बात है कि कोलकाता पुलिस का काम क्या है आज के डेट में? जस्टिस देने का ना. पूरा देश जस्टिस मांग रहा है. पूरा पश्चिम बंगाल रास्ते के ऊपर खड़ा हो गया जस्टिस मांगने के लिए. तो वो लोग का वो काम नहीं है जो सीबीआई को मदद करे, सीबीआई को सपोर्ट करे. स्पाइनलेस पुलिस, कोई इसका मेरुदंड विहीन पुलिस, ज्यादा निजेदर कोनो स्पाइन नहीं. वो लोग अभी सोशल मीडिया में नजर दिया, कौन कौन लोग कर रहे हैं, कितना लोगों को समन भेजेंगे, कितना लोग को लाल बाजार में जाएगा है. करोड़ों करोड़ों लोग हैं पश्चिम बंगाल में. सब लोग एक साथ हम लोग जाएंगे, मीडिया वाला सब लोग देखेंगे कि हम लोग जा रहे हैं. लेकिन काम उनका है ये सोशल मीडिया छोड़ के इसको विचार देने के लिए, इसको मदद करना चाहिए सीबीआई को.
कोलकाता हाईकोर्ट की सिफारिश पर यह मामला सीबीआई को सौंपा गया है. सीबीआई लगातार पूछताछ में लगी है. हमें आशा है जल्द शीघ्र अच्छे नतीजे निकले.
देखिए, एक बात स्पष्ट हो चुकी है कि तृणमूल कांग्रेस की सरकार की प्राथमिकता बलात्कारी बचाव है, अपराधी बचाव है, सबूत मिटाओ, डॉक्टर डराओ, परंतु बेटी को न्याय मत दिलाओ. और इसी श्रृंखला में आज देखिए ना, मीडिया में छपा है कि आरजी कर मेडिकल कॉलेज में जिसने हिंसा और तोड़फोड़ की वो टीएमसी के कार्यकर्ता है. उसके बावजूद भी कोलकाता पुलिस, बंगाल पुलिस की प्राथमिकता क्या है? डॉक्टर को नोटिस दो, लॉकेट चैटर्जी को बुलाओ, मतलब अपराधी मत पकड़ो, बाकी सब की जुबान चुप करा दो. पर जो संविधान बचाने की बात करते हैं, राहुल गांधी, प्रियंका वाड्रा, मल्लिकार्जुन खड़गे जी, प्रियंका चतुर्वेदी जी, आम आदमी पार्टी, इंडिया अलायंस, ये सारे लोग गायब कहाँ हैं? ये मिसिंग इन एक्शन क्यों है?
देखिए, आरजीकर मेडिकल कॉलेज की घटना अत्यंत हृदय विदारक है, पीड़ादायक है, दुखदायी है और कल्पना नहीं की जा सकती जितनी दरिंदगी उस जूनियर डॉक्टर के साथ हुई. अब वो मामला सीबीआई के पास है, उसके मुख्य अभियुक्त की गिरफ्तारी हो चुकी है. जिन लोगों पे और कार्रवाई करने की आवश्यकता है वो कार्रवाई बिल्कुल होनी चाहिए. और मैं ऐसी मांग करता हूं कि सीबीआई इस मामले को जल्द से जल्द फास्ट ट्रैक कोर्ट में चलाकर इस मामले को जल्द से जल्द दोषियों को सख्त, ऐसी सख्त सजा दी जाए कि वो एक उदाहरण बने.
Speaking of investigations, let's also talk about the family of the victim. The victim's father has slammed Mamata Banerjee and her government, says we are unhappy with the chief minister and that no one from the department and the college is cooperating with the family. Also says when the chief minister herself wants justice, she comes on the road and now she's stopping the public from taking to streets. So that's the reaction that's coming from the father of the victim of this brutal, brutal incident. We first up listen in to the victim's father.
नहीं नहीं, हमसे बात नहीं हुआ उसके, कोई बात नहीं. वो ना उन्होंने जरूरत पड़ा कोई सिग्नेचर विग्नेचर का, उन्होंने बोला हम उनको हमारा ऑफिस में आने के लिए बोलो. एकदम हम लोग का डिपार्टमेंट का कोई नहीं और कॉलेज का कोई हमारा साथ कोऑपरेट नहीं किया. पहले से तो हम ये बोल रहा है, यही तो दिक्कत है हम लोगों का, जो डिपार्टमेंट पूरा इसलिए इन्वॉल्व है इसमें.
Going across to Kamalika, joining us on the phone line. Kamalika, the family of the victim absolutely not satisfied with the manner in which investigations are shaping up and have called out the manner in which, you know, the authorities, the hospital management are not cooperating with the family. What could you make of the conversation, or rather, you know, this brief reaction that's coming from the victim's father?
That's what they have been saying, and that is the reason for which they went to the court. They went to the court, and in their petition they wrote that they were made to sit for 3 hours, which the state has confronted by saying that this is not true. They have said that it was told to them that their daughter was unwell, and then it was told that she has committed suicide. And now also they are saying that they have some problem with the hospital, that probably they communicated also to the chief minister. That's what they are saying. And also they don't want any compensation now, because they want justice first. And the fact that so many people are coming out and supporting them, and, you know, coming for the justice and all these things, they, at least their consolation is this. That's what they have been saying. But the fact is, they are still waiting for justice. And now that the case is in CBI, CBI is in just investigating. But till now, in CBI also, they have not come out with any concrete anything apart from questioning Dr. Sandeep Ghosh. Mm. So, you know, they want justice, they are waiting. But
and you know, Kamalika, the family seems to be sending out a larger message that it doesn't stop at one single arrest. It doesn't stop with, you know, the simultaneous questioning that is taking place of the ex-principal of R.G. Kerr. There is lots more that needs to be found out, and that's how the court also reacted. The court also came down strongly on the hospital administration and the cops in the earlier hearing.
Yes, because there was some wrong role of the hospital, which the parents believe by all means. And they are sticking to that point. And that's where they are feeling that they are not, you know, the hospital authorities are not cooperating. It is from that perspective they have been saying all these things.
Okay, many thanks, Kamalika, for joining us with all those details. Speaking of the kind of anger and sadness in the medical community, there's also politics over the R.G. Kerr horror, and it continues to be seen on a daily basis with more and more questions being raised around the law and order situation in the state. In fact, the biggest football game in Kolkata, the Duran Cup between Mohun Bagan and East Bengal, which was scheduled at the Salt Lake Stadium, has now been cancelled because of the prevailing unrest in the city. In fact, the police has said they can't give enough security personnel or enough deployment due to other engagements, and the BJP has used this against the TMC, has questioned the current law and order situation in the state. Listen in.
Yet another evidence of Mamata Banerjee's government's complete incompetence and law and order failure has come to the fore when the West Bengal police has cancelled the permission granted for 18th August match in Kolkata, which was one of the most awaited matches between East Bengal and Mohun Bagan, citing that there are security reasons and they cannot provide security cover. If you can't protect a stadium, how will you protect the entire state with crores of people? This means you have admitted you are incompetent. But is that the real reason? Some people suggest that in this match, people would have come with protest flags, with protest placards, exposing Mamata Banerjee in this entire R.G. Kerr medical gang rape and murder case. And therefore, the dictatorial Mamata Banerjee has issued a fatwa and got this match cancelled.